Hey guys, this is Lita from Sipnotech. So you have your brand new Google Pixel 2 and it's naked, fully naked, brand new. And you don't want to drop it down two flights of stairs like I did with my Pixel 1, so you probably want to protect it with a little something. Here we have cases that are available right now from two sellers who were kind enough to send them over to us. Rinky is one of them, and I think we've reviewed stuff with them before. And here we have another case from Rage Torque, a UK-based case maker. Let's take a look and see. So we have three TPU cases right here. They're all available now, and we'll put links in the descriptions in case you're interested. These two right here are both from Rinky. We've got one clear one and one in a textured, beveled, I guess, smoky black kind of color. This one right here is from Rage Torque, and it's got a pretty nice, just good feel to it. Basic, but solid. These two Rinky ones, I believe, are both $8, and they've got a little bit of a difference. You can see this black one is a little bit thinner, and this clear one is a little thicker. Both of them feel really nice in the hand. So now I'm putting on the Rinky clear one. Ooh. I like the way this feels so far. I think for $8, it's a pretty good steal. On the side here, we have the buttons, which are still very much accessible. As you guys can see, the volume rocker is easily reached. On the bottom, we have plenty enough room for our USB-C charger. And most importantly, on the back, we have room for the fingerprint scanner and a good oval shaped here for the camera. So overall, pretty impressed with this. Very solid for $8. Here we have another Rinky case that they sent us. This one's got the texture and the bevel. You guys can probably tell here that it's got a darker color to it. They're calling it a smoke black. I think it's nice. My phone is already black, so it definitely gives it a darker feel. I'm really liking the texture on the back. It gives it a little bit more of a design, but also it just makes it a little easy to hold in the hand. Just not as smooth. As you guys can see here, we still have enough room for the fingerprint scanner, and just like the other Rinky case, an oval-shaped cutout here for the camera. So lots of good space. Same thing here on the bottom for the USB-C charging port, and as well as the power and volume rocker here. And of course, we can still access Google Assistant through the squeeze. So pretty good. Between this one and the clear one, if you're looking for a little more color and a little more design, this bevel one is pretty nice. So here we have our third case, which is from Rage Torque. As you guys can see, the cutout here on the fingerprint scanner is a little different from the Rinky ones. You've got a little more space, so if your finger tends to move around more in the back, this might be a good option for you. On the camera side, we've got a little unsymmetrical kind of look right here. It's kind of different from the oval. I like it. It looks pretty good. On the sides right here, we have the front of it. It's got a little bit of a lip along the sides, like the other ones. Once again, I kind of like this because if you drop your phone on the front and the screen hits the cement or whatever, it gives it a little bit of added protection. On the left side right here, we have our volume rocker and power button. The feel of it is a little more smooth and not as clicky as the Rinky ones. So if you're OCD and you like the clicky noise, then maybe consider the other ones. I think it feels pretty good though, in my opinion. And on the bottom here, we have the space for the USB-C charging port. Overall, I like the way this one feels too. It's clear, simple, and it just has a little bit of a different design on the back from the Rinky ones. Personally, for me, I think that I prefer a little less space on the fingerprint scanner, but that's just a preference. So for initial launch, I don't think you can really go wrong with any of these three cases. They're basic, they're solid, they're made pretty well. I've definitely seen worse. I've seen it where nothing fits what it's supposed to, but these definitely do the job. And I think for the price, you really can't go wrong with it. Thank you so much to Rage Torque and Rinky for sending these to us. Let me know what kind of cases you guys are considering for your Pixel. Put it in the comments below. I look forward to reading them. See you guys soon. Bye. If you like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, hit the bell button below so that you don't miss a single video in the future. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.